Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. It's Monday, the 22nd of April, 2013. I'm Captain Dave Owen. I just want to talk to you here for a couple minutes about the exercise we're doing this week. This week is exercise Reliant Gale. That is a typhoon readiness exercise that I'll be running Monday all the way through Friday. As a result, you'll be seeing announcements and messages on setting various levels of typhoon condition of readiness. We'll be going through, stepping through our checklists. We'll be taking actions as if we have a real typhoon coming. The exercise typhoon name is Yokosuka, so that's what we've named the exercise coming in this week. So just want to make sure that everybody's aware that we are doing this exercise this week. And this is a great time for the commands to check their preparedness, and it's a great time for everybody to do a sanity check on their emergency preparedness. Things such as, do you have everything you need in your emergency kits? And not only just take a look at what you need for a typhoon, you can also look at things for like earthquakes and tsunamis and other disasters. A good source, last Friday in the base paper, the Seahawk, it's dedicated to preparedness and disaster preparedness specifically. It talks about what to do during a typhoon. It talks about what to do during an earthquake. On the very back of it, it has a checklist of things that you could put into your emergency kits. So if you don't have a copy of this, it'd be a good idea to pick one up. There's lots of them available at the Fleet and Family Service Center. There's also usually the commissary has a stack of them. And it's available online via the CFAY website. So you can go through, make sure you got those items. I mean, there's the ones that stand out, obviously. Make sure you've got bottled water, you got plenty of batteries. If you have small children, for example, especially infants, you make sure you got enough formula. Make sure you've got diapers. Also, if you have pets, it also talks about how to be prepared for your pets in case you get a disaster. And of course, nothing can ever cover every scenario and everything. Some common sense prevails into it. Example, for an earthquake, what do you do during an earthquake? Well, in most cases, the answer is you're just going to take cover in whatever building you're in right now. But if you happen to be in a building that was built before World War II, like my command headquarters up here, it's probably smarter to try to get out of the building and away from it because it stands a better chance of collapsing during a serious earthquake. So make sure you take a look at your surroundings and develop your situational awareness. Same thing like if you get a typhoon or a tsunami, the place to come to take shelter for it probably is not here at the installation. You probably want to take deep shelter and hunker down wherever you live out in town. The reason I say that is keep in mind the installation, it's a peninsula. We've got water surrounding us on three sides. If a typhoon or a tsunami was to hit here, we'd probably take more damage and more problems than where you probably live if you live off base. I mean, we actually push people away from the base when those situations occur. And we evacuate areas like down around Berkey Field because it's high flooding areas in those conditions. So again, the common sense prevails, but this is a good week, again, to go through and look at all your disaster preparedness. Have your plans ready, get your kits up to speed, and that's what this is all about this week with the typhoon readiness exercise, Reliant Gale. With that, I hope you have a great week, and even though we're doing a typhoon exercise, the sun is shining and it's a really nice day, so stay safe, CFAY.